الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثات بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series Majalis Shahr Ramadan by Sheikh Muhammad Salih Al Uthaymeen. Settings of Ramadan or Gathering of Ramadan. By Sheikh Muhammad bin Salih Al Uthaymeen. May Allah send mercy in his soul. And segment number 4, which is the setting number 2, according to the book, chapter concerning virtues of fasting, Fadlu Siyam. إخواني اعلموا أن الصوم من أفضل العبادات وأجل الطاعات، جاءت بفضله الآثار ونقلت فيه بين الناس الأخبار. Dear respected brothers, you have to know that the form of worship of fasting, one of the most noble acts of worship, that a lot of statement in Quran and Hadith had came to let us know about the virtues of fasting. As example, from the virtues of fasting, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it obligation upon all the nations before us as well as us, by saying in Surah Al-Baqarah, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Which is the meaning is, O who you believe, fasting been ordained for you as it been ordained for those before you, that you may learn the taqwa, the fear of Allah. If the fasting is not such a great thing, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to make it upon everybody and every nation that came before us? In actuality, due to the fact that fasting is something, a great form of ibadah, that people could not live without it, Allah made it obligatory upon all nations as well as us. All nations came before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, evidence and a proof for this, ومن فضائل الصوم في رمضان أنه سبب لمغفرة الذنوب وتكفير السيئات. فعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Among the virtues of Ramadan or the fasting of Ramadan, that fasting is a means and way for forgiveness and expiation of the sins, as it came in the hadith reported by Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying what the meaning is: whosoever observes the fasting of Ramadan out of fear and hope, Allah will make it a means of expiation, means of forgiveness for all his past sin. When we say imanan, we mean imanan billahi wa ridan bi fardiyati as-sawm alayhi wa ihtisaban li thawmi li thawabi wa ajri wa lam yakun karihan li fardihi wa la shakkan fi thawabi wa ajri fa inna Allah yaghfiru lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbihi. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it with a condition, which is that you fast out of fear and hope. What we mean by here by out of fear and hope, that mean believing in Allah, believing in the obligation of fasting, and hoping for Allah's reward and the blessings. That mean he did not deny the fact that fasting is from Islam, do not deny that fasting is Allah ordained, not having doubt, and he do this out of fear and out of hope, fear of be punished if he neglected, hope that Allah will reward him and forgive his sins. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عن أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الصلوات الخمس والجمعة إلى الجمعة ورمضان إلى رمضان مكفرات ما بينهن إذا اجتنبت الكبائر. Also came in the hadith of Abu Huraira that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying the five obligatory prayer and Jum'ah to the next Jum'ah and from one Ramadan to the next Ramadan became a means of expiation for the sins as long as you stay away from the major sins. Number three, to show us the great reward of fasting, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not make limitation or certain numbers for the blessings that you get due to your fasting. But he said, بَلْ يُعْتَى الصَّائِمُ أَجْرَهُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not put a limit how much he will give you a blessings for fasting, but he left it open. As it came in hadith Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, قال الله تعالى كل عمل ابن آدم له إلا الصوم فإنه لي وأنا أجزي به والصيام جنة فإذا كان يوم صوم أحدكم فلا يرفث ولا يسخب فإن سابه أحد أو قاتله فليقل إني صائم والذي نفس محمد بيده لخلوف فم الصائم أطيب عند الله من ريح المسك للصائم فرحتان يفرحهما إذا أفطر فرح بفطره وإذا لقي ربه فرح بصومه. So here in this hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying that Allah Almighty saying in the hadith القدسي, in the holy hadith, all deed of son of Adam is for him, with exception of fasting. Sawm is for me, i.e. Allah, and I am the one who will reward him for it. Indeed, fasting is a protection. So when one of you in fasting, he is not supposed to be committing sin, not to act in foolish manner. If anybody argue with him or debate with him or fight with him, let him not to act in the same manner, but he should say, I am fasting. I swear by the one who hold my soul in his hand, that the smell of the mouth of the fasting person dearer to Allah more than the smell of the musk. The fasting person have two joys. One, when he break his fast, he's happy by eating and breaking his fast. And the second joy, that when meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment, he will be happy with his fasting because the great reward that he will get. And also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, كُلُّ عَمَلِ ابْنَ آدَمْ لَهُ يُضَاعَفُ الْحَسَنَةُ بَعَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهَا إِلَى سُبْعَمَاءَ الضِّعْفِ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى إِلَّا الصَّوْمُ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ يَدَعُ شَهْوَتَهُ وَطَعَامَهُ مِنْ أَجْلِي. It came in the collection of Imam Muslim, the hadith, all deed of son of Adam will be multiplied. That means he will get for every good deed one blessing. And every one blessing, Allah multiplied to 10 times. And maybe also Allah will give it to some other people, multiplied 700 times. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this for all his good deed with exception of the fasting. That means the fasting, you get more than 700. Allah is saying, indeed, fasting is for me, and I am the one who will reward the fasting person with no measurement or with no numbers. With this, inshallah, we come to conclusion of this segment. Jazakumullah khairan for listening and patient for my lousy translation. Allah knows best. Jazakumullah khair. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك and Allah knows best. Remember now that Fajr comes at 5:22. So by tomorrow max, okay, we're going to be praying at 5:45. Okay, we give a break today, we've given a break tomorrow, inshallah, but after this, the Iqamah will be the latest 5:45. Jazakumullah khair. You do your suhoor at home, and by the time you finish and you drive, you have at least 20 minutes to arrive here, inshallah. Yeah. Jazakumullah khairan. Ya Allah, ya Kareem. Inshallah. MashaAllah. Have a good day, everybody, on the Facebook.